some tape over of Helen Reddy, but before we go to the tape, let's talk about your acting career for a few seconds. You're taking acting lessons at the present
time. Right, I'm studying presently with Jeff Corey and Devera Marcus, and I wouldn't mind taking some lessons from Paul Rodriguez.
The comedian Paul Rodriguez.
Right.
What about,
well, I'm taking some also improv, which is comedy, with Devera Marcus, and I'm ready to go out there now.
What about a film? I understand a film might be made of your life. Is that correct?
Yes, we're working on that right at this time, and I've got some other projects that I'm working on with a producer at a major studio.
You teach self-defense for women, and we're going to show a piece of Helen Reddy. Why don't we look at the piece, and then you can describe exactly what's going on, and how do you teach these people, and who do you teach, and why do you teach them?
Okay. Right here, what we're doing is also Kali, what you saw me doing earlier with the sword, but we're working with two sticks. And we work with two sticks because it develops your coordination a lot faster. And everything you do with the sticks, you can apply without. And right now, what she's doing is this develops her accuracy and power hitting the mitts. Those are what we call the mitts. So, because a lot of people that take self-defense classes never actually hit or make contact with anything. So they don't know what it's like, so they get really, like, shocked when they have to.
As a matter of fact, you said that about martial artists.
Sure.
You said that 80% of them, many of them black belt,
have never been hit before, and it's not necessary to be hit when you train. I don't hit my students, but by training with equipment, which a lot of arts don't do, you get the feeling and the accuracy of actually hitting something or mm-hmm. somebody,
well,
right?
Don't hit me when we go to this break.
When
we go to the break, when we come back, you're going to show a couple of, what do you call them?
Whatever you want to learn.
Okay, get your pencil and papers, because she's going to give you a phone number where to call if you need more information.
Thank you.
My only time I'll get the hitter without her defending herself. Wow. Anyway, welcome back to Pace Setters. You're going to teach us a couple of things that
right.
you teach women. Mm-hmm. What? How many classes?
Well, no, this is just very basic. If you don't have a lot of training, so just simple things that you could do.
You could do a slow motion. I'm going to go for your purse first.
This is something that happens quite often. Somebody grabs your purse.
It's happening all the time in Los Angeles.
Yes, and you want to react immediately.
Oh,
okay.
Yeah.
The
yeah.
point is that as soon as you feel the person going, you turn your body.
Okay. What you're doing is element of surprise.
Exactly, but it's the angle of the body turning, and you can catch them with the elbow first.
Okay,
and
do it fast now.
Okay.
You want them to do it fast, right?
Well, sure, you just react.
All right, lady, give me your purse! Okay, all right. Oh, boy, what an actress.
Okay.
You're going to make it. Okay, do the other part.
Another common thing that happens, if somebody went for your neck, it's just an angle of sweeping your hands away that you can break the grip of the person.
Show them first before
we do
it.
Okay, so you would go this way.
And
not straight up, because if the person is really strong and they grab your neck, you can't break away this way.
Right.
But if it's with an angle, grab, come out.
Oh, my
See?
God, it's playing strong. Well, one more time, do it quickly.
Okay. You want to try to catch them before they grab your neck, but if they grab it, it'll still work.
Yeah, you're right.
And then right from there, you can just hit.
Oh, my gosh.
Unless you but you want to get away as fast as you can, so if once you break away, the best thing to do is...
Take
right.
off. That's what
Take
you
off.
Sit down. Make yourself comfortable.
Okay.
And you can keep the purse.
Thank you.
But what you're saying is that you're not there to fight the person.
No.
Element of surprise and take off like a bandit,
especially
right?
Especially if you're not highly skilled and, you know, if you haven't had a lot of training. And even if you are highly skilled, you know how to get away faster with less effort.
Mm-hmm.
So what you want to do is just, the element of surprise is what a woman has to her advantage, and speed, agility, if you don't need the power. So you want to defend, you know, distract the person and get away.
You teach these classes. Where at, and how many times a week, and how can they get a hold of you?
Okay, I teach in various areas in Los Angeles, but I teach for the Tech Fitness Health Spa, which is a chain in Los Angeles.
Do they have to be a member of the group?
You don't have to be a member to come to my classes, and I think it'll be easier if I just give a general number, because depending on where a person lives, they might want to come
All
to
right.
a different class. 395-6030.
You're hired now.
Thank you. That's where you can get information, you know, if you're interested in taking a class.
Do women take this seriously once they take the class, or do they go for fun?
Well, women come for different reasons. I have some women come to me strictly for the self-defense. Other women just want it to keep fit. Some women want to lose weight. And not just women, but also men. Some people just like the artistic aspect of it. They want to develop the discipline and the focus and concentration. There's a lot of reasons why you would come to my class.
Have you ever had a positive testimonial of somebody who had taken your class and had been assaulted at one time?
Oh, definitely. I've had a couple of my students, women who have had situations like that.
And they took care of themselves?
Yes, yes.
Let's talk about money. You've been working for 10 years boxing and karate, off and on. You're a champion. You have a master's degree. You're studying acting. Do you want to make a lot of money?
Of course I want to make a lot of money.
Is that important to you?
Well, no, it's not as important as just having a visible career. I like entertaining people. I have to admit that at first when I got in the boxing ring, it was one of the motivating forces was because I was teaching and I wanted to modify my technique. But once I was in the ring, I realized that I liked the acceptance and the applause of the crowd. And it was just real exciting. It's a real high to be out there in front of people. And so now, to me, the ring is a very small limelight compared to the, to a screen. So I just want a bigger platform now to express myself.
Some of the viewers might consider this a sexist question because I might not ask a...
It's okay, Ray. You can...
Well, the truth is, I might not ask the same question to a male boxer who might be sitting there. What about marriage, boyfriends, that sort of thing?
I'm working on it.
You're working on it?
No, at this point in my life, I'm really focusing on my career, my film career, but I date.
Does it take up a lot of your time?
No marriage prospects, but, well, my priority right now is my career, so I have a lot of friends.
What about the fact that your parents are involved with you, with the fact that you have 11 children, and it would seem to me you have a very
I don't have 11 children.
I know you don't, but...
I don't have any children.
Your parents do. You must be a close family. What about that?
We're a very close family. I have 8 brothers, which makes it real nice. If there were a lot of other girls, I'd probably be real upset. But I love my brothers, and they spoil me, so...
And they protected you, right?
They're protective, right. They're not as protective as they used to be. I can go to the store by myself now.
If you received a phone call right this minute, who would you like it to be from? A producer, director, an acting friend, a boxing person said, I got $100,000 for you for a match?
Not boxing, a producer saying I've got a lead in a film.
How about a karate film like Bruce Lee?
Well, that's interesting. I obviously, some of the first films I'll probably do will be martial arts because it's obviously what I'm the best at this point. But I could never be a female Bruce Lee, but what I have in common with Bruce is that we both have the desire to have a visible career, a great film career. And not only that, I hope to bring to the screen what Bruce brought, which was the charisma, the energy that he was able to
exude.
Exactly.
I'll tell you what, the people out there are wondering if they're going to see her in a few years. I think they will. I thank you for being on the program.
Thank you, Ray.
And thank you for watching Pacesetters.